It's the 13th of June 2024 and I'm in my 2024 Tesla Model Y. And Teslas just keep getting better because of these over-the-air updates. And in the last few weeks, there's been quite a few updates. We've had a completely new user interface. But in version 2024.20, the adaptive lights have changed and the adaptive lights now adapt for curves in the road. So you've got cornering lights. So in this video, I'm going to see whether I can notice that and try to show you how that works. So one thing you do need to do is under lights, you do need to have your adaptive lights turned on, obviously. So let's see whether we can see any difference and see whether this shows up on camera. It's also a wet, drizzly night tonight, and I've seen some chatter online and people think the latest update has improved the auto wipers as well, so we can see whether that's the case. But so far, the auto wipers are working fine. So we've got a corner here. Can I see any difference? Not yet. I really need to go around the corner faster, but I'm balancing the camera on top of the dashboard. If I go too fast on this bumpy road, it's going to throw the camera to one side. Got a corner here. He kept his lights on main beam, so I couldn't see mine. Bit of a bend there. Nah, I can't see any difference yet. I suspect they need to be much tighter corners. So I'm sure some people will comment and say cornering lights is nothing new. Of course, it's taken Tesla a long time to implement something like this, and of course it's not new. I had cars 20 years ago that had adaptive lights which turned when you turn the steering wheel. But this isn't the same technology. This is LED matrix lights, so it's changing the pattern of the lights with LED pixels, and it's going to change that pattern again when you turn around a corner to give you a bit more light around the bend. But I'm sure it's working. But so far, I'm not noticing it. I've got some better bends here. Let's have a look, and I'm doing 42 miles an hour. No, I can't. I really can't notice the pattern changing. So, I'm sure it's working, obviously, because the software says it is, so it's doing something, but maybe it's so good that I'm not noticing it and it's just lighting up around the corner without me noticing it changing. But I'm not seeing the pattern change. Or maybe the corners aren't sharp enough, or maybe I'm not going fast enough, or the angle's not right. But I've been driving about 15 minutes now, attacking every corner that I can find locally, and I haven't seen any shift at all with the pattern. So I'm doing 60, no I'm not, I'm doing 50 miles an hour, because it's a 50 mile an hour road. Right, so I'm doing 50 miles an hour into this corner. No, I didn't notice that shift. What I am noticing is the lights are very good. Right, the adaptive beam is changing there. That's because of the reflection of the road signs. But I'm not noticing any shift of the beam to light up around the corner whatsoever. So let's try this corner here. Ooh, I did notice something there. Light up the left-hand bank more, but it didn't light up the right-hand bank more there. So if it is working, it's subtle, or so good that it's just lighting up everything and I'm not noticing it shift. I also, now look at that, the auto wipers just aren't working well enough. So yeah, that's not fixed. I also did just do some low speed manoeuvring at a junction and also turn the vehicle around. And I was amongst hedgerows and was watching the lights light up the hedgerow when I was turning the steering, and I wasn't seeing any shifting then, even at low speed. So it's a shame. I thought I would notice more of a difference with this. All I can say is the adaptive matrix lights are very good. But as for the cornering part of it, so far it's not noticeable. So I've got a sharp left-hand corner here. Change in the lights there. Another left hand corner here. No. I would just add, the image you're getting out of the camera is quite dark. It's not picking up the headlights, the light from the headlights, as well as I can see it. My camera's not particularly good in the dark. So I've got a right hand bend here. Very sharp one. Oh yes, I noticed it there, slightly. It lit up the right hand side a bit more as I turned. Oh, there's a deer there. Make sure there's not another one, I don't want to hit another one of them. So yes, I did possibly notice a difference there. So my feedback following this latest software upgrade really is, don't expect much. The LED matrix headlights still work really well, but you're not going to notice a difference when you're driving around corners. It's a shame, because I thought I was going to be able to see a difference and show it on video. So finally, the auto wipers. They've definitely improved with the latest software update. They've never worked this well. I've been driving about 40 minutes now in the drizzle, and they've been on auto wipers all the time, and I haven't yet needed to correct them. So they're still not perfect, they're still not as good as a vehicle with a rain sensor, and that's every other car out there, but they've definitely improved. If you don't know, Tesla doesn't have rain sensors in their cars. They rely on the camera to work out when there's water on the windscreen, and they've struggled with that, particularly in the drizzle. But it's been okay tonight. There's been times where it's wipe the glass too many times and it's still a bit dry, and there's been times where it's gone on to high speed and it didn't need to, but there was only a few wipes and it wasn't long enough that I needed to change the setting. So yeah, they're getting better. I've also seen online that there is an update coming where you can adjust the sensitivity, and that may well crack it. So I suspect we're only a few more updates away from them finally getting auto wipers to work properly. So that'll do for this video. It's a shame I haven't been able to show you the cornering working on these LED matrix headlights, but I tried, but yeah, it's just not visible. So I apologise, it's a bit of a boring one, but anyway, if you found it useful or interesting, please do click the thumbs up, because that really does help, helps to get the videos noticed. Also, if you want to know more about Tesla Model Y, there's a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made on this vehicle. And I'll see you on the next one.